Welcome, all friends of the Dhamma. Clear knowing. Just ask you a question. Knowing my talk, knowing sitting, same knowing or not? You know my talk? And you know your sitting? Can you know together? Can you know together? My talk and your sitting? Yeah, if you know by awareness, okay? If you know by concentration, this is samatha. You know my talk, you don't know you're sitting. You keep concentration on your sitting. You know you're sitting, maybe sometime you don't know my talk. So samatha, we know by concentration. Vipassana, we know by awareness. Okay. And now, know you are sitting, know you are breathing, same knowing or not? Can you know all together? How you sit, how you breathe, and where is knowing? Knowing got no movement. Okay. But what you know got movement? Breathing got movement, sitting what got movement, okay? But knowing got no movement. So that's why if you develop knowing all together, it become equanimity of mind, okay? Equanimity of mind is the door go to Dhamma eye, equanimity of mind, okay? So that's why we need to develop knowing by awareness or vipassana. Okay? Knowing your sitting, knowing your thought, same knowing or not? Can you know all together you are sitting and sometimes you got thought, sometimes no thought, sometimes more thought, sometimes less thought, and know you're sitting together? But most people practice, most practitioners always practicing knowing thought, seeing thought, but don't know sitting. So that is knowing by concentration to develop calmness of mind. But if you want knowledge, knowing to develop, knowing to be knowledge, you must know from awareness. Can you know now? How you sit, how you thinking, how you feeling. Can you know same time all together? Even everything not knowing, not happening at the same time. But at a time, can you know all together? At a time. Okay? The Buddha or the enlightened one, at a time, know all together. Whatever happening right now, all together. How you say in English? No, all together. Omniscient. Correct or not? Omniscient. So now you maybe 0.01% of omniscient. Not 1%, only 0.0001 omniscient, because you always look and lost, listen and lost. Okay, can you know you are seeing, you are listening? You must keep knowing together, then you're not lost, then it become more omniscient. 10%, 20%. The enlightened one is omniscient. Okay? It looks like the Buddha is omnipresent everywhere. Omnipresent everywhere. Okay, because the Buddha mind is equality of mind. Know everything in the universe. 10 universe, 10,000 universe. Omniscient. Okay? So that's why this is my question. because most practitioner practice meditation concentration samatha by concentration yes I agree samatha you need concentration but again most practitioner practice vipassana also by concentration this is my question because we would like to follow the Buddha path to the omniscient okay we must know more and more 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 and more together all together at a moment but now 10 year 20 year do we doing vipassana by concentration this is I not agree but if for samatha I agree okay so that's why you practice vipassana but actually you not practice vipassana you practice samatha because you use concentration okay so that's why I found that vipassana we know by awareness now you know by awareness you know together how you doing how you feeling okay now you know two at a time that is body and mind and how about can you know three or four at a time because the Buddha say you must practice the four foundation of mindfulness can you know how you doing how you breathing how you sitting how you feeling how you thinking how you feeling how you attach something you still attach something can you know all together that's why about 20 years ago I just have this question for a long long time because I go to any temple samatha they teach me concentration but vipassana they always teach me concentration I don't agree okay so that's why this is my question the Buddha is omniscient okay omniscient okay so now I just find the way myself because I am very good at samatha concentration from 20 years old I practice samatha 30 and about 40 years old I just think why vipassana still do concentration because when you do concentration you not let go you not let go okay so that's why I start find a way myself so I just develop more awareness seeing by awareness so now just know together how you doing how you sitting how you breathing how you feeling how you got anything in your heart inside deeply can you know all together you must stay very neutral your mind very neutral then you can know all together you need very good mindfulness excellent mindfulness make your mind neutral no self then you know all together after I got this keyword now I start practice more awareness because I'm very good at concentration deep concentration until fall asleep sometimes concentration until fall asleep so that's why now nobody teaching me knowing all together nobody teaching I think I am the first teacher who teaching knowing all together about 20 years ago the first teacher okay after that some teacher also teaching know all together after I teaching this about a year or 2 years then I heard that teacher teaching knowing all together now next 3 years that teacher teaching knowing all together and I write my book about knowing all together in Thai and that time 20 years ago about 16 years ago nobody teaching all together everybody teaching concentration my book is the first book after that ajahn this ajahn teaching knowing all together maybe he find out by himself but it's maybe the same what I find out knowing all together okay So now when you know all together you must apply, keep apply. When you know all together you got more awareness. More awareness is look like turn over. Beyond worry life to super mundane life. And now again when I practice knowing all together something holding me inside not allow me to know all together. Oh, very difficult. Because the way you practice in your perception, you got attachment, you must focus something, okay? That is holding me inside. But anyhow, one day, I just got my technique. Okay, smile. And when you smile, your eyes see it happened that my heart can see. My heart can see what I'm seeing. Okay, my heart can see. And when I see from my heart, I can see all together, outside and myself. This is what I find out. I can see all together, surrounding and myself who is sitting in the surrounding. Oh, now I just train myself not only knowing all together. You must train yourself seeing all together. After you got knowing, seeing all together. Oh, yeah. Understand why people got blocked, cannot go to omniscient, the Buddha enlightened. Okay? Cannot. Okay? So this is my question. And now, many master in Thailand now just full awareness knowing all together now many teacher and you can see even in the Burmese tradition there is one ajahn I don't know I cannot remember his name I'm not sure he teaching full awareness. Only one Burmese monk, other monk teaching concentration. This monk only teaching full awareness. Okay, I'm not sure what his name, but I got his book as well from Bodhidharma, full awareness. And then now I just quite sure now, okay, because this is the way to go to develop neutral mind. Neutral mind is just know what you know, okay? Not choose. When you not choose, you know all together. Now I practice more know all together. And then what happening? Now when you got samatha, quality of mind is still and calm. But if you not know all together, what happened? You got no vipassana, you got no insight, you got still and calm. And very dull, dull. After you know all together, you get foundation of samadhi, samatha, very good samadhi, samatha. And after you develop knowing all together, it happened that your mind, your heart, very good response, good responding. Can see things very quickly, very fast. Wow. Very fast, your mind, your heart, sitting, arising, disappear, okay, very fast. That's why vipassana, we develop full awareness, we develop seeing, knowing, seeing all together, or we develop more responding. Normally, when you listen to my talk, you lost responding to your body sitting. You lost responding to your sensation of the whole body. You lost responding of your breathing. When you keep more attention on my talk, then you focus my talk, then you lost responding to yourself. That is the key point. okay when you got more responding it become knowing clearly knowing full awareness with knowing and all emptiness regarding selfness regarding the past and the future all emptiness what not emptiness is full awareness full knowing about breathing sensation body movement or whatever feeling in your mind you got full awareness and it difficult to develop full awareness and get over all attachment inside okay so I just found that we need to get full awareness of body first okay with full awareness of body then you can get full awareness of hearing seeing touching and feeling and desire and you can get over attachment okay if only concentration 20 years cannot get over not only attachment you cannot get over nivala five okay so up and top you cannot get over maybe you practice 20 years you still cannot get over desire or so up and top and or agitation or ill will or whatever the five hindrance okay you cannot get over concentration cannot get over okay full awareness only can get over okay so that's why I'm quite sure I just learn from my experience and then when I can get over first I found knowing at the knowing okay knowing whatever object outside usually you know the object and very close you know you're knowing very close to the object no gap between the knower and object okay so to develop knowing wake up you need to develop knower first knower gunman because always your mind always concentration outside cannot keep access concentration so that's why I start with the technique to develop gunman or access concentration first and then I got power enough to get over when you got awareness of whatever when you got gunman you got access concentration or one pointedness of mind whatever you know you can get over okay and then after I develop one pointedness of mind according to samatha is it mean if you got one pointedness of mind you got fulfillment of samatha and then when you got fulfillment of samatha next how you get over your desire and all attachment how okay stillness of mind cannot get over when you not stay still you still got anger desire again you cannot get over so that's why I got this question and then okay then I practiced concentration samadhi 20 years but I cannot get over my anger okay before I lost in anger when I practiced concentration but now no anger I always smile because I develop awareness and more smile more opening then clear knowing not movement and clear knowing can learn whatever happening with clear knowing you can learn anything and you get knowledge okay if not clear knowing and sometimes agitation then what you learn you cannot get knowledge okay clear knowing when you learn you can get knowledge okay so that's why If I tell you I teaching samatha meditation, I will teach you one practice of mind, the gunman. Okay? Watch, notice to make it very powerful. But if I teach you vipassana, I will, if I tell you I teach you vipassana, that means I just stay mindful. At the gunman, one practice of mind, I just stay mindful. Okay, it really good stillness already. Then just be mindful. Then it become emptiness of thought. Be mindful and now develop more awareness, full awareness, more and more and more by knowing all together. Okay, now be mindful and knowing all together. Can you know all together, how you sit, how you feel, how you breathing? When you know all together, you must keep your body upright and your knowing become knowing. Wake up and knowing. Just not do anything. Stay calm with good mindfulness. The gunman, mindful, not stillness now. When you do your vipassana, from stillness of mind, you transform to mindfulness. Okay? Mindfulness. Mindfulness and be mindful and know what you know, see what you see. First, you cannot know clearly because you never know by heart. After you know by heart more and more, then it become know clearly. And it become clear knowing, wake up. And when you got clear knowing, next, you learn by clear knowing. Anicjang, Thukhang, and Anatta. You got knowledge. When you got knowledge, then it look like you know from knowledge, see from knowledge, okay? Knowing from knowledge, seeing from knowledge. So today we start clear knowing first, okay? I will teach you this way, samatha with one pointedness of mind, the gunman, the one pointedness of mind, but vipassana, I will teach you maybe let's say three step vipassana, three step to teach you because this is what I practice myself. First, develop awareness by feeling. First lesson, vipassana. Develop awareness by feeling. Can you feel your breathing and know your breathing? Feeling and know. Feeling and know. Feeling and aware. Aware, knowing. Feeling and aware, knowing. Feeling your breathing and aware. Aware with knowing. Aware not with thought. Not with thought, aware with pure knowing. Okay? This is the first lesson I always teaching vipassana. Develop feeling and know, not thinking and know, not concentration and know, not looking and know, not focus and know. That is samatha, meditation. Now, can you feel how you sit and know? Know how you feel. You feel your body. Can you know together with awareness, more you feel your body, feeling will develop awareness, wake up. Feeling you are sitting, then can you know you're sitting without thought? Feeling you are doing bodily movement, then can you know your bodily movement without thought? Feeling and know. This is the first lesson, okay? Feeling, breathing, and know. Feeling, breathing in, and know. Feeling, breathing out, and know. In the beginning, you always get used to samatha technique. Focus your breath and breathing. Then when you focus feeling, cannot get feeling because you focus already. Okay? So when I teach you vipassana meditation, I always tell you develop awareness by feeling. Especially feeling your heart's mind. Can you keep your feeling your heart's mind and know? This is first lesson to develop vipassana, knowing. with awareness, awareness of feeling. Very easy, awareness of feeling. Feeling smile, awareness of your smile, then you know your smile. Awareness of smile, you know your smile, more and more you know your smile, it happen to see your, it becomes seeing your smile as well, okay? So when you got knowing and seeing your smile, knowing and feeling your breathing and know your breathing until feeling and know, and feeling and know and see together. When you got know and see together, that means you pass lesson one, three lesson. After you pass lesson one, then lesson two, knowing all together. Because more you train yourself, feeling and know, feeling body and know, feeling sitting and know, feeling your movement and know, feeling your breathing and know, feeling your sensation and know. When you train in this way, feeling and know, you got awareness, knowing all together. Okay? Awareness, knowing all together. Then you just knowing what you know. Don't try to know, just know what you know, just know what you know. Walking, know you're walking, sitting, you know you are walking, breathing, know you're breathing, okay? Don't have any doubt, okay? It's correct or not correct, doesn't matter. But know what you're doing and know, feeling and know, breathing and know what you know what you know. Then when you got seeing together, then you already passed lesson two, okay? Lesson two. And when you got knowing and seeing from knowing, knowing become seeing already. Now you got seeing anicchang, dukkhang anatta. Easily if you got seeing already. Okay. But if you not develop knowing and know, you don't have seeing, wake up. When you see anicchang, you always see anicchang by concentration. You can see anicchang only in the starting. After you concentration more, it becomes still and cannot see clearly. It very dull, still and dull and calm and dull and want to stay calm, not want to learn. When you got stillness too much, you don't want to learn anything, only still. And then you only got still and got presentness in joy and happiness. Don't want to develop vipassana when you got very still, stillness of mind. So that's why when you develop knowing all together, don't worry about your mind, how to still your mind. Only stay calm as you can. Okay? Stay calm as you can. Now can you stay calm? And what is your knowledge? Or what is your knowing? You knowing rising, falling up the whole body. And what is your knowledge? When you got knowing, you got knowledge. Knowledge anicchang dukkhang anatta. Stay calm. And what is your knowing? Doesn't matter what is your knowing. Your knowledge is anicchang dukkhang anatta. That's right. Okay. Only three lessons. Three lessons for vipassana. Okay. Three lessons. This is from my experience. No, you cannot get this teaching from any book. Because it's from my experience to wake up, how to wake up, okay? Now, stay calm, always starting with stay calm. Now we develop knowing clearly first, okay? Knowing clearly. And one thing you must rely, when you got more knowing clearly, you got clear knowing. Clear knowing is equality of mind. No movement. Clear knowing, no movement. But what you know, got movement. So how to know that clear knowing got no movement? if you know all together, you can know all together got movement, body got movement, sensation got movement, mind got movement. But when what you know is from knowing all together, full awareness, it got no movement. So stay calm, knowing all together, got no movement. More got no movement, it become clear knowing. And it become omniscient by itself. But not like the Buddha. It's only omniscient today, 5%. Before you got zero. Okay, 5 or 10% of omniscient. It look like you do meditation for learning, for knowledge, more knowledge, to attain omniscient. Okay? So that's why now you can know all together, rising, falling of the whole body, sensation of body, sensation of breathing. You need very good mindfulness that you not have any disturb or doubt when you know all together. Because when you know anything, you always got doubt, okay? Doubt or agitation block your knowing clearly, okay? Knowing all together, simple, by opening eye. What happened to you? You will find the fact that knowing got no movement. You find the fact that knowing got no movement. Whatever you know got movement. Okay? More you know all together and don't do anything. Just know all together. So, generally, more knowing all together, outside, inside, together. Knowing all together. Whatever you know outside, inside, got movement, got vibration, got web, got swaying. But knowing, not swaying. Knowing got no swaying. Then you rely knowing got no swaying. Knowing happening by itself. Wow! Okay, all the Buddha nature. Now, knowing all together before you cross your eye. More you can know all together, you got more vipassana. And samatha, you don't need to practice samatha. Because today I just tell you, just stay calm. You practice calmness for more than 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. Today, just stay with calmness or stay calm. And know all together. If you smile a bit or have trust in Buddha, you can know all together outside and inside deeply into mental state if you smile. If you not smile, you know all together only outside, only outside and inside a bit only. So knowing all together, now what happening? Clear knowing happening. Here knowing expanding. And that is the middle way. Stay there. All in the knowing. And what you know in the knowing? Got movement, got vibration, got pulsation, got movement, got rising, disappearing, got rising, got falling in your knowing all together, got rising, falling, got arising, disappearing, got movement, got vibration, got sensation, got pulsation, okay? Got activities, okay? But knowing, no activity, only knowing. Knowing all together. Stay calm and mindful knowing all together. Wake up. Wake up your mind by knowing all together. You feel your mind wake up or not when you know all together? And wake up more and more. Become one with the nature. You got feeling like you wake up more and more as same you sitting in the sky. And you feel really light. But the sky or the feeling of light, lightness got movement as well. So you must know all together what happening, the lightness or whatever of joy. Joy and happiness got movement all also. Then you have to stay knowing all together. No sitting, no breathing, no joy, no really lightness inside. What you know got movement, but knowing itself got no movement. Then your mind wake up, no, your knowing wake up like a big mirror, a big and clear mirror with good exposure or good response to whatever happening, arising, disappearing, okay? Very good response now. Knowing all together. So you can open eyes sometime because we not do any concentration. We develop knowing all together from inside until not only inside, it all together inside and outside. Now you're knowing all together, but not all together because you only try to keep knowing from inside. Okay, you must relax the whole body. Okay. And keep it natural, then it got knowing all together inside and outside. So that's why open eye and see surrounding together will help you know outside. Because when you close your eye, the problem is you know only inside. This is the big problem of practitioner. So you need to balance knowing inside and outside together. Okay? When you open eye, you know inside and outside together or not? All together, okay? That is the point. And then it become a big mirror with clear mirror, with exposure, sensing, or responding. This is jhana. This is jhana. Vipassana jhana, knowing all together. So just develop now, open eye again. You can find it's very simple to develop all together at your home, at your office. Oh, sorry, you not go office now, at home, stay home. Can you know all together? You know, this, every afternoon session, now I got knowing all together when I teaching in the Russian session because I need to be a foreman of my construction and teaching and foreman and teacher and foreman and teacher. Afternoon session. That's why I know all together. I talk to the labor. I know what you practice. I talk to you. I know what my labor doing or not, doing job or not. I know all together. That's why I start to be omniscient now. I start to be omniscient. So what I practice, nobody tell you. What is enlightened? Practice to be omniscient. If you omniscient, you need very good mindfulness. Otherwise, you got agitation. Because know many things, very difficult. Okay? Know many things and manage everything together. Very difficult. You need very neutral mind. Okay? Very neutral mind. Now close your eye. You got wake up already, knowing all together. You got my teaching already. That is what we can rely access to enlightenment, knowing all together. It's more responding, more responding. Clear mind as a big mirror, more responding. Everything become only web. What I call movement or arising, disappearing, is only web. It's the same app. The light got web, the sound got web. When you know all together, your body become web. Okay. Or in Burmese tradition, they use the word rising and falling. Okay. Actually, it is the same web as web, rising and falling, rising and falling. When you know all together, everything become rising and falling, rising and falling. Dancing, it's dancing. But you're not dancing. What you know dancing? Rising and falling, rising and falling. And you stay mindful with knowing, and not dancing with rising and falling, only knowing and let go, knowing and let go, knowing, understanding, and let go, accept all impermanent. What you rely dancing or rising, falling is anicca and anatta there, okay? Now you feel very quiet and you see rising and falling of sensation, rising and falling of pulsation, rising inside, rising and falling of breathing, rising and falling of feeling, rising and falling of all emotion, rising and falling of all mental state or not. Can you rely that? And then you break through all rising and falling because what you know is rising and falling, but knowing God know rising and falling. Then you wake up. Mind is knowing, not rising and falling. But what the mind know is rising and falling. Okay? Now open your eye. You open eye, you got movement. You got doing that, doing this, you got rising, falling, but knowing God, no rising and falling. So you know where knowing is. Equanimity of mind or neutral mind, knowing is neutral or equanimous. No rising and falling, but near equality of mind, near knowing, very near, got perception, agitation, or itchiness. Near your heart, itchy from desire, okay? And you know already, this is rising and falling, not pure mind. And where pure mind, just know whatever you know what you know what you know what you know, everything will go away, and then clear mind, wake up, no rising and falling. Very good. You get over what disturb you already, you get over already. And clear my wake up. Knowing what you know, seeing what you see, more you just know, just see, you can see whatever you know and see is only rising and falling. Then you got breakthrough from knowing clearly, clearly knowing not movement, no rising and falling. And clear knowing wake up, especially when you open eye, your eye open, it got connect to the clear knowing. Wake up, okay? So now knowing my talk, knowing you are sitting, knowing you are breathing, what you know, my talk, you are sitting, you are breathing, got rising and falling, but knowing got no rising and falling. Just stay there with mindfulness, awareness of knowing, mindfulness, awareness of knowing the pure mind, the clearness inside. And open your eye widely, see surrounding and know. So know what you're seeing. Can you know what you're seeing? Surrounding, you see surrounding. Can you know seeing surrounding? All surrounding got rising and falling. Anicca got changing. But you know surrounding, knowing surrounding, no rising and falling. Neutral. Whatever you know, it got rising and falling. But the knowing always neutral. Okay? You got it already. I'm very glad today. I make very difficult teaching very simple for you. Okay, now just share it to everybody in your family and in your country. And you can rely, your feeling got rising and falling. But mindfulness, knowing together, knowing not lost with any rising and falling, knowing still neutral. And there you always stay with the Buddha nature. And may the Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha show you the way to Dhamma eye, attaining the Buddha teaching in this very life. And we end today's session.